you have a good day. Today I'm back with another video of Noob Adventures. This is episode 2 and this is where we left off last time that I played this. Hey, a slime is spawning here. That's the slime that's supposed to be near a mushroom spirit. So that means that somebody is fighting that mushroom spirit. Let's see if I can beat this slime here with my stick. To go close enough to it. Well, it's gonna take a lot of hits, blue slime. And why actually are you spawning here? Because you aren't even supposed to be here. I wonder if it will give me XP if I kill this slime, because if you kill slimes in caves, it gives you a lot of XP. You can level up quite good by killing slimes. But usually the slimes that spawn from bosses, they don't give you any XP, so that's what I'm wondering, and that's why I'm going to finish this off. You blue slime, you are going to die. That's 1 XP for my token. That's not because I'm hitting this slime here and doing 0.5 damage with my stick. Well, slime's out of there and didn't give me any XP, sadly. Let's take some of these cave berry sprouts with me, because they are low for the backpack and they give some leaves which I can use to craft arrows with, which I can use as soon as I can craft a bow. I'm not of a high enough level yet, as you can see we're only level 4 right now. Take those cave berries and those leaves. And let's also break this gold, because breaking down gold is not a very high tier ore, but it's also not the lowest tier ore, like a stone, for example, or some driftwood. And this will give me quite a lot of XP. So these guys, they came and checked me out, but they are quite friendly. They are not attacking me or anything. They're also not going after my gold. Thanks for that, guys. They clearly were working together. And they could have easily ambushed me, and if I would have my wooden harvester equipped, they could have taken my harvester, but I guess they weren't interested in a wooden harvester, as they were a little bit higher level than me and could already craft better harvesters. I'm safe here as a newbie, and it's nice, people are kind to me. Let's go get this large seaweed. I needed some for the quest master, and if you cook that seaweed, you can eat it when it's raw, but you can also cook it, and then it becomes poison seaweed, and if you eat it then, it will make you very sick, it will make you feel very unpleasant. And as you can see in the right bottom corner of the screen, there's 3 bars that you can look at for the statistics. It's your health bar, it's the backspace bar, and how much hunger you have. So you always have to keep an eye on your health and your hunger, and make sure that you eat in time, otherwise you will die of starvation. And if you are dying in this game, your screen will blink red for a second, so that's a very good notification to know that or someone is attacking you, or you are dying of starvation. I will take those seeds with me as soon as I can craft the plant box, and I will put those seeds in there, and as soon as the crop dies, it will give me some XP again, so I will keep those seeds. That's Banana Island on the left. Bananas are good. You can gather bananas if you need food. They're good for hunger and they're good for healing. So we are again here at this place where the quest master is and the resource trader. But, I'm going to grab that egg there. That Easter egg. And if you've seen the previous video, the Easter eggs are not in the game anymore. The Easter glider can't be obtained anymore. It was only an event. That's why also I have this backpack, and it doesn't show the real backpack skin, but it shows as an Easter egg backpack. Basket. It's a basket with eggs. Because I'm collecting eggs for Mr. Hobbs. Well, I got all that gold. I need to make room in my bag. Inspect an egg. Before I go get that gold, I should actually craft myself a campfire and show you how to cook some things, because some things need to be cooked, like that seaweed, which you can then use as a poison seaweed to trick people with, for example. You can give it to them as a joke, or you can use it to commit suicide. Well, there's a campfire. You can craft it if you're low level, a campfire, and you can use it to cook ores in. All ores except volcanic ores. As soon as you are a little bit higher level, you will want to craft yourself a furnace instead of a campfire, because with a furnace everything cooks much faster. But for now we have to do with the campfire. Could put more down, but I don't have enough resources in my bag. And as you will see, cooking this stuff, it will again gather XP for me, so it will help me level up. And that's why silver and gold, a ruby, diamond, if you can find those ores, break them down. You will gather XP from breaking them, and you will gather XP from cooking them. Level up that way and kill slimes all the way. So we are waiting for the gold to cook. And we're gonna take that gold, hoping when we reach a high enough level we can craft a silver or a gold backpack. Maybe skip one of these backpacks. Take the rock with me as well. And I'm really not in any stage yet that I can PvP, that I can challenge people. I don't have a sword, I don't have any type of armor, I don't have a bow. But soon enough I will be able to PvP with people. There, I leveled up again. And my bag is also full again. Let's see, I can craft a bigger bag now. We can upgrade to the hard leather bag, but I do not have the resources. So there's two things I can do, or I can go gather the resources so I can craft that bag, or I can go level up a little bit more and hope I can skip that backpack and actually level up enough to be able to craft the backpack for the next level, which should be a silver backpack. And that will give even more backspace. Again, more gold. Fast forward, and this is behind the resource trader and the quest master, and as you can see there's a wall there, and it goes, if you want to break walls down, any kind of barriers like walls for example, then it goes the fastest if you use a sword. And I don't have a sword yet, so let's first gather some resources so I can craft myself a wooden sword and equip myself for the task ahead. And that will empty out my bag a little bit more so I can gather those resources that are behind this wall. If you're low level, this cave is quite okay to gather some resources, and there might even be some rubai in there. Right now it's only silver, gold and some stones. So let's gather those, let's break them down, let's go after the high tier rocks first, as time is of the essence. I'd rather have this gold in my backpack than that I would have that stone in my backpack. I emptied this cave out, there's a slime there, and I'm gonna kill that slime with my sword, and then you will see that killing slimes will give you a good amount of XP. This one gave me 9. The deeper you are in the cave systems, the more XP the slimes will give. There's blue slimes, orange slimes and green slimes. And the orange slimes are the hardest to kill, not that they're difficult. And you can gather those slimes, and they take up very little backspace. And with slime I can craft myself slime armor, and that's quite a good use when you have to fight against slimes and other mobs. or a low level guy, if you can craft yourself some slime armor in PvP versus gold armor, it's not good. Gold armor is better than slime armor in PvP. I hope next episode I will get some more interactions with people, because that will be exciting, of course, to see what will happen then. Thanks for watching again.